comes the moon. Oh yeah. Here comes the moon. Beautiful. Looks like it's a hair, the thinnest of hairs, beyond first quarter. That is, it looks like it's just a faint touch more than half lit up. Look at that. Now that movement of the moon slowly crawling across the screen, that is not my camera. That is the moon moving across the sky very, very slowly. Because where I am, where we all are on the earth, we're turning from daylight into night. You know, I asked my mother the other night, a week or so ago, I said, "Tell me, what is the night?" Oh, and she started giving me the usual metaphors, explanations. It took me almost half an hour to bring her around to the question and the answer, I mean, I was looking for. Physically, what causes night? And the fact is, the night for us here on the earth is caused when we turn away from the sun and into the shadow of the earth. Now that dark part to the left on the moon, that's where the sun is not shining. The shadow of the moon stretches off to the left, off into space. About 6 days from now, we'll have the full moon, the great giant full moon. It's election night. Election afternoon, election eve. And I am waiting with great anticipation and great sadness. Look, the wind is shaking my camera. I'm waiting for the results. Anticipation because I'm curious and fascinated and want to know who's going to win and what's going to happen. And sadness because I expected, I had planned, we had planned to be in the beautiful hotel in Yosemite Valley at a special dinner tonight. But we're not there. I am very upset about that. But there's really nothing I can do. I is watch the sunset. And in a little while, go in and listen to the television again. It's, as I said before, Tuesday, the 8th of November, the year of our Lord 2016, by the Jewish calendar this is the year 5777. '77, '77, 2016. Time of year, we can't see the sunset from our house because it goes over there behind the neighbors' houses, over there in the trees. We can't see it. Can't see it set because it goes into their house. Over there behind the bushes. It's already gone down behind the houses. And now all I can do is look at it out in the valley. Yep. Oops. Tim was watching my video from day before yesterday, and he said that bridge was hellishly noisy, but that bridge is not the noise you hear. That bridge is almost a mile away. The noise you hear is from down there. Right below our house is where the noisy part of the freeway is, in Freeway Valley. But it's not as pretty as the bridge across Freeway Valley. So I tend to focus in on that one. I zoom way in. Catch last rays of light. Lighting up the bridge. You know, I say I'm disappointed that we didn't go to Yosemite Valley. But then I come out here and I look at this, my stepfather's backyard. This lot, which isn't large, it's sort of the size of a usual city lot around here, just happens to be on the edge of the hillside. This piece of land was given to him and his first wife, my stepbrother and stepsister's mother, their mother, Jane. She had three children with my stepfather. She succumbed to her illness in the 1970s. Couple of years before my father died. And then in 1978, my mother and my stepfather, who had been friends many, many years before and might have gotten married in 1941 or 1942, except the war came and sent them off in different directions. My mom met my dad in New York when she was back east for training. My mom was in the Navy. My dad was studying at the Merchant Marine Academy in Kings Point, which is on Long Island in New York. And my mom had gone back to Smith College to study for the waves. And she was introduced to my dad on a blind date in New York City in 1942 or 1943, and they ended up getting married. They had two children. And my stepfather married a young woman here from San Diego. They had three children. And that's why there are now five brothers and sisters, me and my youngest brother, my baby brother, who's 8 years younger than I am. And between him and I are my stepfather's three children. Her eldest is a daughter, my stepsister, and then her two brothers. The five of us are now in our 50s and 60s, years of age. We lost my stepfather 9 years ago. And my stepmother, excuse me, my mother, their stepmother, my mother. I can't keep the story straight, gotta get a scorecard. She still lives here. My stepfather said she could live here. All she had to do was pay for the utilities. The trust he set up would pay for the taxes and maintenance of the house. And my mom, shortly after my stepfather died, asked me to come and live with her. And that's when I left Tijuana, although I still have my apartment there. I've been paying for it ever since then. I'm thinking about letting it go because, well, even though my mom said she couldn't go on the trip this week, she's still in pretty good health.
and I just don't know how long I'll be here. You can see by the light over there that it's getting pretty late in the day. It's almost sunset. Time is going on. I've been recording for almost, almost 17 minutes now. But I come out here and I look at this view, and although I'm sad that we're not in Yosemite where the view would be much more spectacular, I'm still grateful that I have a place like this that I can come out. Even with all the noise of the traffic, I can still look out over Freeway Valley. The evening sink into the west. Well, like I said, we won't be seeing any sunset today because sun goes down behind the neighbors' houses. Over there. Those are their houses over there in the trees. It just might be able to pick out the window of the house over there. Now there's a house. Over there, on the other side of the house, they can see the sunset. Yep. But not here. You can't see it here, no. Sometimes it creeps up on me. I really was looking forward to the dinner tonight and four different California vineyards would be presenting their wines with dinner. And afterwards, we could retire to the hotel bar, watch the election returns. But no, it was not to be. These are the days, last few years of my mother's life, and I need to just take it easy and go slow and not let myself get upset. The end comes to all of us. Slowly or quickly. And now, the end is coming to this video. Good night, my friends. I'm going to say something really sort of corny. But here it is. God bless you all.